Hey, welcome to Mammoth Online. Today we are looking into case 3 of quadratic inequality. There are two quadratics which are having an inequality in between. This can be less than equal to, greater than equal to. Any of the following possibilities are there. I have taken a special scenario where both quadratics have this kind of notation. 2x square minus 4x plus 7 and x square plus x plus 3. These are the two quadratics we have taken. One way to solve this whole question, this is the one of the way, method 1, is directly trying to plot these two graphs. So let's say one of the function is f of x, and that f of x is written by 2x square minus 4x plus 7. We have another function g of x, which is x square plus x plus 3. The question is, f of x should be less than g of x, right? So when I plot f of x and g of x on the graph, we see these are the possibility we are getting. We're clearly seeing this is our f of x. The brown graph is our f of x, and our g of x is somewhat here. And I can see that this is the point of intersection. Somewhere here, at 1 it is intersecting, and at 2, x equal to 2, it is intersecting. Y value, I'm not that much concerned because I want the places where it is greater than, and this intersection, so x can tell me all about it. What I see from here is very simple. If I put 1 here, I can even find the value here if you want. If I put 1 here, I'll get 2 minus 4 plus 7, that is minus 2 plus 7, that is 5. So it is 1,5 over here. The question is, f of x should be less than g of x. The brown graph is f of x, the yellow graph is g of x. Where is f of x less than g of x? F of x is less than g of x only in these places. So from 1 to 2, f of x is less than g of x. All these places, it's clearly seen that f of x is less than g of x. This is our f of x and this is our g of x. Clearly g of x is above f of x. So let's take that interval. Our answer should be 1 to 2. The other method to work with is this, where we are gonna do very simple procedure. Using algebra and manipulation, I'm gonna bring all these terms over here, or I can say I'm gonna add minus x square on both sides, that will eliminate x square. So steps are very simple. The next step is I'm gonna add minus x square on both sides. This will give us x square minus 4x plus 7 less than x plus 3. Now I'll add x plus 3 on both sides, minus of x plus 3 on both sides. Anyways, the idea is I'm going to end up with x square minus 5x plus 4 equal less than 0. So as I can see, when I simplify this algebraically, I can see x minus 1 and x minus 3. And then if I try to plot on a number line, I can clearly see that 1,3, this is 1, at 1 it is 0, and at 3 it is 0. So beyond 3 it is positive, in between 1 and 3 it is negative, and beyond 1 till infinity it is positive. So the solution is where it is less than 0. So that is 1 to 3. So our solution is going to be 1 to 3. Now these are different cases, x minus 1 and x minus 3. So as I can clearly see, this is a place where graph is positive, or the number line representation is positive. Even the graphs look somewhat similar, but please understand this is a curve representing the positive area in number line for the graph. This is not the graph itself. Please understand. Goes something like this. This goes something like this. So where is it less than equal to 0? Less than is at open interval 1 to 3. Less than equal to means solution to this is wherever it is equal to 0, at 1 and 3 they are equal to 0, at that is taken, and between 1 and 3 it is definitely less than 0. Greater than, when I talk about greater than, you can clearly see minus infinity to 1 it is greater than, and 3 to infinity it is greater than, right? What about this one? I can clearly see minus infinity to 1 it is greater than equal to, and 3 to infinity it is greater than. So these are the three scenarios we see, and these are the solution for all the three scenarios.